another Irish love poem, more personal this time, though I see it's called The Irish Unionists' Farewell to Greta Hellstrom in 1922. It happened that the girl looked like a Swede, which is unusual in Ireland. Golden-haired and golden-hearted, I would ever have you be as you were when last we parted, smiling slow and sad at me. Oh, the fighting down of passion, oh, the centuries seeming tale, parting in this offhand fashion, in Dungarvan, in the rain. Slanting eyes of blue, unweeping, stands my Swedish beauty, where gusts of Irish rain are sweeping round the statue in the square. Corner boys against the walling watch us furtively in vain, and the Angelus is calling through Dungarvan in the rain. Gales along the Cumberland mountains, beating sleet on creaking signs. Iron gutters turn to fountains, and the windscreen laced with lines. And the evening getting later, and the ache increased again, as the distance grows the greater from Dungarvan in the rain. There is no one now to wonder what eccentric sits in state, while the beech trees rock and thunder round his gate lodge and his gate. Gone the ornamental plaster, gone the overgrown domain, and the car goes.
Ulster is the key to the defence of Ireland. To make it neutral would mean handing over that key to Hitler. A neutral Ulster is impossible. We mean to stand by Britain and the Empire.
And get Ulster into the Republic if they want a fight in their hands. Ulster's lives the King, God bless him.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. All good children go to heaven. You never get tired walking backwards. Well, Peter, this is Cara Ray. Wonderful country.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yeah, that's the beautiful Burnside Valley.
From a military point of view, I think I'd be very worried, because over the last 4 or 5 years, the Irish have been very much been fighting a lost cause, indeed fighting without a cause. I think that now it's going to polarise communities again, and we're going to go back a number of years, and a lot of ground that has been made at the loss of lives and at great expense, our expense, is going to be lost.
Who will die rather than pull down the flag. There are men in Ulster who will stand to the last man in defense of their heritage. And the sooner the British politicians awake to that fact, the better.